All right, so is it clear what these answers are?
Let's find out. So let's see. We already worked out the math on this, so we know that for gamma greater than 1/6, cooperating is better than defecting in general. So if I'm going against someone who's always going to cooperate, then I should always cooperate.
Incorrect.
What?
Yes. So we didn't actually work that out. What we worked out was what to do if you're playing against tit for tat. If you're playing against someone who's always cooperating and is completely oblivious
No, you're right. You should always defect because you're always going to win.
You're always going to win. You're going to get zero on every time step.
Right.
Yeah.
No, that makes sense. That's beautiful.
All right. What about always defect?
Well, if you're always going to defect, you might as well defect.
Indeed.
Because we're just in the regular old prisoner's dilemma world.
Good. All right. So now we have this other strange beast here. So our opponent is playing tit for tat. So we could always defect.
Right.
But we get a higher score if we can convince tit for tat to cooperate with us.
For gamma greater than a sixth.
That's right.
So that you should always cooperate.
That is true. However,
mm-hmm.
What if we play tit for tat against tit for tat?
You'll end up in the same place.
Yeah. So that's just as good.
Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of interesting. If you think about mutual best responses.
Yes.
So that's a strategy that, a pair of strategies, where each is a best response to the other. We have another name for that. Do you remember?
No.
You told us what it was.
Yeah, but I probably use different words.
It's a Nash equilibrium. That's what a Nash equilibrium is. A pair of strategies where each is a best response to the other. There's no way that either would prefer to switch to something else to get higher reward.
And that makes perfect sense. You're in an equilibrium. And it is a Nash equilibrium. Okay.
So we can use this little table here to actually identify Nash equilibrium. So what would a strategy be? So if one player plays always cooperate, then the best response to that is always defect.
Mm-hmm.
But the best response to always defect is always defect. So always cooperate is not part of a Nash equilibrium.
Right.
But what about always defect versus always defect?
No, it is.
So that's a Nash, right?
Yep.
Because they're both doing the thing that is the best response to the other.
Right.
All right, this box here, always cooperate against tit for tat, that's not okay. Because if a player does always cooperate, it's always better to switch to always defect.
Yep.
But check this out. If you are playing tit for tat and the other player's playing tit for tat, there's no reason to switch because it's actually a best response. It's the optimal thing to do. And that works from both players' perspectives.
And that makes sense. So, like you said, check this out, and you've been using check marks. That's very good. So, we're in this situation where we have two Nash equilibria.
Indeed, and one of these Nash equilibria is cooperative, which is the thing that we were sad about, or at least that I was feeling really sad about in the last lesson, the idea that, man, it's clear that they should just try to get along. You explained that you can modify the reward structure, and then they would get along better. But here, it turns out, well, no, another thing you can do is just open it up to the possibility of playing multiple rounds. As long as you don't know how many rounds, it becomes possible to have a strategy that is best off cooperating and is, in fact, a Nash equilibrium.
Isn't that equivalent to changing the reward structure?
It's definitely related to changing the reward structure. It's a particular way of changing it.
A very particular way.
Yeah, because it's not true anymore that we can do this in the one-shot case. You have to be in the repeated game setting.
Right. So you change your reward structure to be a sum of rewards, but it's actually an expected sum of rewards, and you don't know where it is you're going to stop. So I guess you change the game. You change the rewards, but in a sort of very subtle way.
Yeah, the whole game is different, really.
Yeah, man, you change the game.
Sometimes you got to change the game. Don't hate the game.
No, you are supposed to hate the game. Don't hate the player. Hate the game.